Hello and welcome to a brand new video. Today we are playing Zelda Twilight Princess for the 26th time. In the previous episode, we completed the Snowpeak Ruins and got ourselves another Mirror Shard, leaving us with two left to get. In this episode, we're going to work our way towards the next one and check on our old friend, the mailman. Greetings, Mr. Gavin. I have come to deliver a letter. It's a letter for you, Gavin. Two letters, in fact. Well, my business concluded. Onward to mail! Now, what could this be? Agatha had a dream last night. Butterflies surrounded Agatha and lifted her up to the sky. As she waved to the people below in Castletown, she could see so many people. Some waving back, others staring wide-eyed. Agatha flew in a big circle above Hyrule Field, and the butterflies formed into a bed beneath her, and she said, "Let's play again." Soon they faded away, and she woke up in her own bed. Oh, Agatha. Agatha wants so badly to fly in the sky. I feel bad. You paid me visit, and I not help much. I feel better now. Husband and I sled lots now. Very much fun. Gavin, you join us at Snowpeak sometime. They don't ever, like, sign these. It's just, like, Yetta doesn't say any. It's interesting. So in the time, because I really haven't done much since the last episode. So in the time I teleported from Snowpeak to here, they've sledded a lot. I mean, I doubt you would have been able to do more than two trips. Is it nighttime? I don't think that should matter too much, to be honest. What's so bad if I go over 4 rupees? Have you brought a bug for Agatha's ball? Dayfly. Oh boy, who's your friend? You're a little dayfly, aren't you, you little cutie? Little dayfly. I want to take your colorful tail and make the loveliest braid ever. Oh boy, thank you so much. I'm so happy. Sharing her happiness as she does. 2 bugs left. We got ourselves a pair. 1 bug left. Can see the fruits of our labor here. And then some. Oh, no, I can't get that. 'Cause I want this. You bought it. You were smart. You bought it at Malamart. This item has been discontinued. Well, I would like to get the blue potion, but I have but 2 rupees to my name now. And that is the magic armor. It's definitely a bit of a gimmick. I don't know why they added it. It looks cool. Well, buddy, I've collected 20 of your souls. Hey, he can move. You did it. I can move again. This is all thanks to you, right? Oh, I have to thank you. Will this do? Thank you. I hear you can get this stuff on a in the cave on the eastern edge of the Gerudo Desert too. But my body is still golden. Does this mean my soul is not whole? That's strange. Maybe we need the souls of 60 ghosts. How does he know these things? Can I ask another favor of you, doggy? Can you just defeat more ghosts? Just 39 more. I can't see my girlfriend looking like this. Doggy, please, just defeat 39 ghosts more. Check up on the bar. There's always something going on at the bar. Telma's bar. Hey, he left. Gavin, huh? The beast of Snowpeak hasn't appeared in Zora's domain since its last visit. In the end, the troubles in Hyrule and the events on Snowpeak were beyond even my imagination. Honestly, there's got to be someone who knows what really happened. It's me! Did you see the sad state of Hyrule Castle? It's the urgent desire of this group and of ours to restore peace to this kingdom as swiftly as possible. Gavin, please continue to lend us your strength. I wonder if the sacred grove that Rusl mentioned is near this mark. Think it is. No, thank you. Yeah, you've already talked to me about them. How's Lilia doing? Na-na-na-na. Hey, honey, if you're up in the air about where to go next, maybe you ought to talk to Rusl. He's in Hyrule's northern wood right now, checking out the lay of the land. If you need detailed instructions, just take a peep at that map on the table. Mean, the only reason I go there is just to see what they say and what's different, but I really don't need my hand held, you know? Like, I know that Rusl is native to Ordon and he's missing, so go check out Ordon. What is useful, though, is I can collect rupees now, even if I don't have enough space for them, because I'll be able to just put on the magic armor and then drain them to the point to where I can use the rupees. But thanks to my brilliant decision to put Epona near Hyrule Castle, I've instantly got transportation to where I need to go. Believe I showed it in the previous episode, but we went into this cave and saw that it was blocked off. But now, thanks to the ball and chain, there is no such thing as blocked off. We've got ourselves yet another puzzle. So this is one of the easier ones. I believe there's three levels, as indicated on the map there. The wrong way. I don't get a da 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 da. Not using a guide for this, although I might have to for the next one. Alrighty, got it figured out. Third and final room. Just one square in the room. And then glory. This, you know, it looks harder than it is, I feel like, you know? Let's find out. Like you at least want one of the blocks to line up with. Oh, I think I got it. I'm a genius! That didn't take me that long at all. I think this took me less time than that heart piece in the... I was worried this was gonna take a lot of brain power. Here we go. I was really hoping for a da na 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 na. All right, two more. Not too bad, huh? Encourage you guys to try that on your own if you're playing through this game. Because, to be honest, not that bad. That leaves just one heart piece before we can go check out Rusl in the Sacred Grove area. It's just rupees sitting there. Everything's so quiet at night. Gavin, you came. Thanks to you, I made it home at last. I think all of us carry heavy hearts, but I will do my best to see that our village's wounds heal as quickly as possible. Come see us anytime, Gavin. You will always be welcome here. There you go. Back on the throne. What? Actually, wait. Curious what you guys have to say about that. All of us in the village are so happy that our young prince has come back. Now that the king and the queen have passed on, do we call our prince the new king? Yeah, that's kind of how it works. Our queen died of a tragic death, but I have not seen the prince weep for her. Seeing his resolve makes me realize we shouldn't mourn her forever. She would have wanted us to move on. You saved our young prince? Oh, let me thank you on behalf of all the Zora people. This is a great day indeed. The throne room status is currently at normal. We have greatly anticipated your return. Well, we aren't accustomed to hosting humans, but please make yourself at home. Is he still back here? He is still back here. Long time since we meet, no. How does time pass in this game? Wife feeling better, nice weather for sleds. You try, race to home. Not sure how many times we have to do this. Whoa! Can run into this bozo. Excuse me, Jackwagon. Fuck. Okay, this is where I can start to lose him. Here we go! I just respawn up here. Ah, video games. Reminds me of DK Summit just because of the Wii instruments. Yeah, purple Roop. This route's much quicker. I mean, I have to do it eventually, so I just gotta keep working on it. What in the world, dude? This is so hard to control. Race to home. Don't have to do it to beat him first, and there's no point in beating him by a lot yet. So, we're gonna take the safer route. Comes the snow part of Snow Peak. Are you serious? Now mad. Oh. Ha 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 ha! You beat Yeddo! You good, Worthy Sledder. You want rematch? You go back to Mountain type, Here, best time of Gavin, 123. You try to break record, It good time. I love Sledder. I race anytime. I guess you guys probably don't mind if I turn into a wolf. I don't think Yetis would be scared by a wolf when their house was infested with them, but... You beat husband, you good. You race me? Good. Race to house, I think she just sleds on her. Yeah. She is much faster than Yeddo. And the only way I believe to beat her is to use that shortcut. Oh, she's right on me. So I've got a slight lead right now, but that will disappear if I don't take that shortcut. Problem is, I've never landed the shortcut yet, so. Oh boy. What do you mean? I landed! Guess they don't like you missing that shortcut. Yes, race, Nah, it really sounds like I'm on DK Summit with Peach right behind me. If you slam it, if you make any mistake, you're not beating her. Huh. You sled down that snow? You race back to my house then, Oh no, not him. I don't know! That's not what I wanted to do. Okay, I think I got her. As long as I can hold this. Oh, yes! Thank the Lord. She was coming in! Shaved 7 seconds off my record. Gavin, you too good, I overconfident, maybe. You slimmer than husband, Maybe that your secret. You aerodynamic, You take this as a token of respect for sled skills, Oh, and no-toe husband. You come back and race anytime. I think he knows. He's right there. And once again, that is every heart piece you have to get before heading to the next temple. Oh, wow. Blindsided.
Yeah.
Here's our buddy. Oh, that's right. This dog's got a thing against humans. I come up to him as Wolf, he's like, nah, I don't care. We meet again. There are but a few hidden skills left for me to teach you. I have warned you of this before, but if you fail to execute the hidden skill I am about to teach you, your life may be forfeit. Do you still wish to master this skill? Very well. But before we begin, I must test you to ensure you have mastered the last secret I taught you, the mortal draw. Now then, come at me! Got it! Excellent. It appears you are certainly capable of performing my lost art. Very well. My sixth hidden skill is the jump strike. Let it be hewn into your mind. Loading. My game crash. Okay. That was weird. One of the basic sword techniques is a jump attack. It inflicts great damage, but none would call it effective against multiple foes. To perform the jump strike, prepare a jump attack, but focus power in your blade. The surge the blade releases can strike all enemies around you. This is the jump strike. Lock on with Z, then press and hold A until just the right time. I see. Seems like a pretty easy one to execute. Oh, he's multiplying! Nice! Impressive. Do not forget the timing for releasing the power you just felt. The sixth hidden skill, the jump strike, has been passed on. The sixth hidden skill. There is but one hidden skill left for me to pass on to you. You are already endowed with the strength required of the hero. Do you not already feel the courage granted by the strength as it guides you step by step towards your true enemy? Believe in your strength. Continue to push forward unflinchingly and without straying from your path. May we meet again. We just may. So I was doing a little bit of research. You can get that hidden skill. I mean, obviously he's there as soon as you sing the song. You can get it before Snoke Peak, but I decided to do it after. But one of the things I ran into was people didn't seem to like that move. But to me, it seems really useful because I am doing the jump strike a lot. See if anything new is here. Probably not. Greetings, Gavin. I felt Ilya could use a change of scenery to improve her health, so we came here. Who knows? If she gets out and sees daily life, perhaps something will jog her memory. Gavin, perhaps you could keep her in your thoughts? Oh, I have them. Oh, Gavin. You have gone through so much trouble for me. I am so sorry. Colin and the others have told me so much about you, Gavin. They tell me that you are brave and kind, and that you heard very well. That means you must be a good rider, huh? Oh, and the name of your horse is Eponag, right? Eponag. What a lovely name. Well, seems like she's doing a little better. That's cool, there's multiple entrances and exits. I'm sure if she saw Epona, that would jog her memory. And I guess we'll get to it at some point. You'd completely forgotten about it. Well, to be honest, I did. I knew there was something down here, I just never checked it. After getting the lantern. I'm not sure if anything happens to the house after you beat the game, but I'll be checking all that stuff out later in this series. How's there a fire going in here? I wonder what Epona thinks of, or Midna thinks of all of this. She's probably really entranced. No, she hates stuff like this. We gotta stick to the mission. We gotta do this. We gotta do that. What if a man just wants a break, huh? Because when I originally did this Let's Play, I got right up to the first temple, so, you know, I've played this area of the game at least 3 or 4 times now. I forgot I could do this by hand. Red Rooper. But I'll give him a 20. Fine. Yeah. Anytime, chap. It has been a while since we took a walk in the forest. Huh? Yes. And how our world has changed. Say, do you know about the far side of this deep gorge? Some say there is an ancient temple deep in the woods that guards a sacred power. The ancestors of the Hylians created the temple. Signs of their civilization, ancient, but very sophisticated, are everywhere. If someone could obtain the power of those ancient people, well, I am sure it would go a long way towards saving Hyrule. Gavin, would you take on this task? Would you cross the gorge and find the ancient power sleeping in the temple? Eh, why not? I knew you would. To cross the gorge, just use my partner here. Constantly wearing a rugby hat. Do you doubt my partner's skills? He flies like a dream, believe me. Well, you will definitely make it across the gorge. Wait and see, my doubting friend. Probably land on that first. There's a chest there. Hold up. I want to die. Somehow this is yet to be opened. A yellow rupee. Good thing I killed myself for that. Okay. Okay, we're gonna land here. I guess on this. Yeah, that did the trick. I get to use this thing. I haven't used it in a while. Oh wait, hold up. We still need that chicken. Kinda thought we'd be done with the chicken. How did we lose a bridge? That doesn't make any sense. I think I still need him. It's down there. Guess who's back, everybody? The one and only. I think that might work. You can follow his light now, which makes this a little easier. I didn't think we'd see Skull Kid again, but I'm glad we are. He's a really cool character, especially, I mean, he's basically got his own game in Majora's Mask. Which way did he go, guys? I see it. Could use some bombs, if you guys want to drop those. Probably a purple rupee. 30 bombs? That's ridiculous. What man needs 30 bombs? I mean, I don't want to, like, kill this poor man, but... I feel a little bad doing this. But when you give me 30 bombs and you give me arrows, there's only one thing I can think of. I think I see it. Those things are everywhere. There he is. Baby. There he is. I wonder if that's a pulse saw on his hand. Somehow I reached him. That was unfair to that guy. Yeah, my dog's going berserk. Uh-oh. That was fun. I'll tell you what, I'll let you into a secret place. Get to go to a secret place. Bunch of birds here. Wait a minute, I've been here. The sacred ancient forest. So this is what they were talking about. Well, that is it for this episode. Thank you guys so much for watching. In the next episode, I will strike my sword into this pedestal and see if anything happens. If not, we've got some more exploring to do. But I will see you guys in the next episode for more Zelda Twilight Princess. Peace.
Subscribe to Gavin Knight.